Canva versus Adobe Express, which is better for your project? In this video, I'm going to walk you through the key advantages of using one of these popular design tools over the other. Let's dive in, starting with the reasons to use Canva over Adobe Express. 1. It's a much more feature-rich tool. Canva gives you access to a range of features that simply aren't available in Adobe Express. These include tools for creating whiteboards, documents, product mockups, and charts. There's even a ChatGPT-style AI content generator built into the platform. While Canva's feature set encompasses a wide range of business use cases, Adobe's feature set is geared fairly exclusively towards design applications. 2. Canva gives you significantly more templates than Adobe Express. A key attraction of using apps like Canva and Adobe Express is the library of ready-made templates they give you to simplify the design process. And Canva gives you a lot more of these, over 600,000 to Adobe Express's 100,000. They cover a lot more categories and use cases too. 3. You get more storage space with Canva. Adobe Express and Canva both provide you with cloud storage space to hold all of your designs and visual assets. But you get a lot more storage space on Canva, 1 terabyte to Adobe's 100 gigabytes. That's 10 times more space, and you'll find this extra storage particularly useful if you're creating videos or high-res content. 4. Canva's video editing features are considerably better than the Adobe Express equivalents. Canva's video editor is more powerful than Adobe Express's, giving you more control over transitions, background removal, and audio. But perhaps most importantly, it also gives you direct access to a huge range of stock videos that you can insert easily into your projects. With Adobe Express, you'll have to source and upload all your video content separately. 5. A wider range of export formats is available in Canva. Canva gives you access to a wider range of output formats than Adobe Express. While Adobe Express limits you to exporting to just 4 file types, Canva caters for 7, including PowerPoint and SVG formats. This gives you more ways to use your visuals outside of the platform. Okay, so that's 5 key areas where we feel Canva beats Adobe Express. But where does Adobe Express win? I'll come to that in just a moment, but before I do, I'd just like to make you aware of 2 things. First, if you're interested in trying Canva out, you'll find a link to a special free trial of the Pro version on screen and in the video description. This lets you access all its premium features for several weeks and is well worth checking out. I'd also like to invite you to like this video, hit the subscribe button, and click the notifications bell. This helps us out and gives you easy access to all our tips, reviews, and offers going forward. Okay, so here are the reasons you might want to use Adobe Express instead of Canva. 1. A background removal tool is available on its free plan. A background removal tool is extremely useful for creating headshots or thumbnails for YouTube videos. And, unlike Canva, Adobe Express lets you use its excellent background removal tool on its free plan. 2. Adobe Express lets you export unflattened PDFs. Unlike Canva, Adobe Express lets you export unflattened PDFs. These files retain all the individual layers of your design as separate items, which means that you can easily edit your work in professional design software. 3. You'll find a lot more typefaces in Adobe Express. If typography is your thing, you'll love the wide range of fonts that are bundled with Adobe Express. You can make use of over 20,000 professional fonts when using the platform, which is significantly more than the 2,000 or so that Canva gives you. Not only that, but the typefaces involved are Adobe Typekit fonts, which are usually of exceptional quality and frequently used in corporate branding. 4. There's a lot more stock photography available from Adobe Express. Adobe Express is more generous than Canva when it comes to providing you with stock images. On its paid plans, you get access to 160 million of them. What's more, they're from Adobe's own stock image library, which has a very high reputation for quality. The only thing to watch out for here is the fact that Adobe can be a bit restrictive regarding how you use these images. Not all applications are catered for, so you'll need to make sure you read the licensing small print before using them. Conclusion. To sum things up, we'd say that overall, Canva is the more feature-rich tool and probably the better option for most users, particularly if you're intending to work with video. However, if you know you're going to need to create unflattened PDFs, want regular access to the Adobe font library, and want access to an extremely large library of stock images, then Adobe Express is worthy of serious consideration too. Of course, the best way to find out which tool is right for you is to try them out yourself, and you'll find links to trials for both apps in the video description. Before I go, a reminder that to get all our latest content, please do like this video, hit subscribe, and click the notifications bell. And finally, if you have any questions, do leave them in the comments section. We read them all and we'll do our best to help.